All right, in this video, we're going to talk about the unification of the Bitcoin standard and tell a story, take it back in time, and exactly where I see this going and how we can really unify all together and take advantage of the biggest opportunity in human history. Long time ago, Satoshi once said that Bitcoin is, when he was asked about the future of Bitcoin, he said, Bitcoin is the future of everything, every single thing. He talked about even like a little Diet Coke can in the middle of the river floating away. It was the have its own little IPv6 address and a little receipt tracked to it on the Bitcoin ledger. I mean, it was the future of everything. Ever since that, I've never understood. I believed it, but I never understood it, and I'm not saying I do yet. But here's the standard that is in front of us right now. Now, last night, Mitch Berman came on the X Space. Raphael, Casey, Alex.Sats. We had John. Bunch great space. And he broke down what the standard it really is. And the standard is called BRC100. All right, now, BRC100 is the Metanet protocol. It's the Metanet built by Babage. nChain tried to build it and failed, and Babage was able to figure it out and put it together. And so basically what it's done is it's taken the machine code of Bitcoin, the archaic, old C++ language of Bitcoin, like the machine code, and turned it into a standard called BRC100. Now, why is that important? Because 7 years ago, however, a number of years ago, I remember hearing about Money Button. And I mean, I was like, wow, I was so impressed. I was like, Money Button, cool. I got it. And I was able to use it. It was really a cool feature. Money Button. Wow. And then I had Money Button not too long ago. I remember I was in Hermosa Beach getting the Money Button, and I was actually working on stuff. And then Money Button went away. I haven't cried about it, but I still have a bunch of Bitcoin on my Money Button. I mean, I'm sure there's a way to get it someday, but I don't know how right now. So I'm sure I can if I find it. But anyways, that thing went away. And because we didn't have a standard, a simple standard wallet protocol, a neutral wallet, without having Money Button, you can't get and use your Bitcoin. So what the BRC100 protocol does is it creates a wallet neutral standard where it's a protocol completely neutral to no matter what the wallet provider is or the company is. It allows entrepreneurs, developers, to build their infrastructure and provide it without having to centralize it and get their users dependent on them in case they go out of business or they leave and now all their customers are screwed. See, what happens, all these Bitcoiners were trying to go to market, and no, you know, entrepreneurs are going to be entrepreneurs. They want to make money. So people in the early days were all trying to go to market. Nobody ever spent the time to build the standard. The infrastructure, not the infrastructure, the language, the computer language, the software, to have a standard, a BRC 100 standard, to where then developers could use the protocol and not have to have their own wallets and change and have these centralized infrastructures. I'm going to put out the space in like segments and videos. So stand by for it, because Mitch really, he had the whole place just freaking silent. He had the whole crowd just silent. Everybody was just like on pins and needles. He dropped so much knowledge and inspiration about Bitcoin that, I mean, it was like the ideas that he had about, I mean, when you say it's the future of everything, I mean, that's, oh yeah, it's so easy to say. But now actually coming up with ideas and how things are changing right now and how they can be changed and how entrepreneurs can do this is exciting, dude. it inspires me to want to really want to learn this. And the challenge that Mitch dropped down, and the one that I'm gonna support, is that just get a base level understanding of this. I have no clue about programming, none. However, as an entrepreneur, I know the importance from my own personal business experience that when I came in, killed it at Americorps as a loan officer, and I freaking did the entire process of how to do it, the loan, A to Z process, everything, you know, call, close the deal, process the loan, everything, you know, sign the loan, everything in detail. I killed it. Then, as I got into my own business, I relied on other people to do each part of this process, the processing of loans, the writing of loans, the selling of loans, the orchestrating of loans. And then I would just oversee all things and try to manage the entire process. Now, excuses aside, yeah, 2008 collapse and the bank stopped loaning money. So yeah, I completely went out of business overnight like that, and because we couldn't fund loans. But had I had the actual hands-on knowledge of every single aspect of the business and how everything worked on a base level layer, I would have been able to make it survive. I would have been able to make it thrive because of that. But because of the lack of knowledge, I had nothing I could do. I people were all leaving. They couldn't get paid. I couldn't pay people because the lights had, you know, the lights were shutting off. We lost revenue. So anyways, my point is that by learning the base layer level of all of this new Bitcoin standard, the BRC 100 standard, the Babage standard, it will allow me and challenge to you to be a better Bitcoiner. That's really what it's about. It's about being a better Bitcoiner, better entrepreneur. When I say Bitcoiner, it's like that. It's like Raphael dropped some knowledge about the Daniel Krawitz videos that he'd made about Bitcoin. Anyways, it's about this connection that Bitcoiners share. And because we're on the same path, and we've been misled for so long about the price going up. And in no way is it a bad thing. Price going up is fine. But we've been so distracted as this kind of this video that Daniel Krawitz had done, talks of references about his monkeys, about the price going up, that we forgot about what Bitcoin actually does and how it actually, the real world problems it actually solves. And as Bitcoiners, the challenge is that we can take the initiative to begin to learn this standard, just the base layer, just the base level. So a base level understanding about how the standard operates in Bitcoin, to where then we can communicate it with others and entrepreneurs and developers, or become a developer or be a better developer. Because I asked Mitch last night, and I heard a rumor that Facebook, Meta, this is off the record, this is not public, but they have a bounty for $1 billion for developers who do large language model coding. A billion dollar bounty to pay a salary to those special, unique developers. That's, how many, what, nine, ten figures? $1 billion. Apparently, there's only like 20 developers in the world that even know how to do that. So that's why the bounty's so high. Well, guess what? This standard is equally as valuable. And also, at this point in time, it's probably equally as thin, if not thinner, with the amount of people who understand it. You got Satoshi, Mitch, Babage, maybe Todd Price, maybe four or five, maybe a handful of others that truly understand the whole standard. I'm sure there's others I'm missing, so no offense. I just don't know off the top of my head. But those who learn it first will be at a huge advantage to everybody else. And all the late comers when, you know, the Ponzi scheme begins to crumble. Because when the crypto Ponzi scheme and the BTC Ponzi crumbles, Well, it's going to crumble because of hash power on Bitcoin, but it'll also crumble because of pure utility. And now that the scalability is there, the rails are built with the scalability. We know that. But now the infrastructure, it's like we have to build the actual businesses. In order to do that, we have to use the standard. In order to use the standard, we have to freaking know what it is. Because I have to learn how the standard even works so that I can begin to formulate ideas and solve these real-world problems. So stay tuned for the next coming shows I'm gonna put out. It was a live last night. It's on my channel right now. You could watch it live, but it was a terrible audio, so I don't recommend watching it live. It's awful. But I'm gonna try to get the recorded version that I have and put it up in pieces so people could watch it because it was so good. You can count on me doing another one of those for sure. All right, so more to come. Hit the ones. My name is Gavin Mehl. All right, the Bitcoin standard, unifying the Bitcoin protocol for the Bitcoiners. This Bitcoin standard, the BRC20 standard by Babage, and a challenge to those to everyone else to begin to learn it. Just a base layer. I'll see you at the top.